top shelf shot by Alferson, who scored on a shootout goal on that exact same shot, but quick release. Pulling back deep in his crease because Alferson skating with speed, pushing him back.
Bench before the overtime started, talking about this with Zetterberg and the rest of the players, and they know Mrazek's a great puck player. Nyquist had the presence of mind and brilliant play to stay up, not going off the ice, and Mrazek noticed.
Anytime it's through people, it's a tough call. You know, you want to make the sure pass for sure so that it doesn't get picked off.
Now back, a stretch pass in the clear. He scores! David Backes, his fifth power play goal on a great feed, and the Blues tie the game at two.
Off the bench on a change after Evander Kane takes that roughing call. What a pass by Alexander Steen. A dart on the far side. There's the line change. The Winnipeg Jets don't pick it up. And Alexander Steen puts it right on the tape to David Backes, who then just rips a high one over the glove side. That's just a great shot right there by David Backes. Very, very confident pass by Alexander Steen.
As you can see, the Bruins wearing their Winter Classic uniforms and hoping to even their record 1-1. There's a sneak away to Bergeron. He deeps. He scores. 45 seconds in.
Booth drags the puck back, holds, sends it through the slot, nobody home. Boychuk, the sneak away to Paille on a breakaway. He scores! That'll count. 3-1 Boston.
What a monster shift by Johnny Boychuk. In favor of Vancouver, and then it was really man-on-man coverage, a lot of one-on-one battles. That's a lengthy shift for a defenseman back in his own zone. Once the puck came into the neutral zone, the Bruins were able to get partial line change, which means Danny Paille is able to step out.
In the penalty to Johnson. Here's a breakaway for Kennedy. Scores! Tyler Kennedy, and the Sharks lead 2-0.
Kennedy steps on the ice. Brent Burns. Look at that. That is absolutely perfect. And Kennedy goes to his forehand. I thought he went far side, but I think, oh, he goes five hole on Bishop. Gets him moving. What a pass by Brent Burns. You can see Burns was almost waiting. That looked like a quarterback waiting for the wide receiver to find the hole. And Kennedy does.
It set up, and then they really didn't have much except for that, you know, busted play and great chance.
Here escapes Callahan. He scores! And then the pass from Anton Strahlman. Seam is open, forehand, backhand, and Lundqvist gets beat.
And there's the someone else that we were talking about. Stamkos in the box, Callahan on the stretch pass, going after his old teammate, Henrik Lundqvist.
Gets it free, but it goes right to Montiel. His shot blocked by Subban, and here's Cavallari. He's out of the box. Cavallari shoots, scores!
The donut, 10 games without a goal, gets Sprung coming out of the box, and this is a shot he's had over and over the last 7-8 games, getting lots of chances. Finally picks the corner right where he wants, just underneath the glove.
Over the lead pass, the goalie Rolison has been pretty good handling the puck, and look at that break! And they come with Pekka! Scores! Pekka scores the goal with Rolison spotting him going down there.
Trying to get to that wraparound spot. Sen's got a lead pass, hopping along! Scores! All that action inside the Ottawa line, and then the long clearing pass, and it's 1-0 Ottawa.
And then what a play here by Carlson. Right over top, high over the forwards, right on the tape. I mean, on the tape of Hoffman, who's been quiet in this series. And he does the old hockey school move. He'll up back with the one hand, completely fools Tuukka Rask.
Very nicely for you. A long stretch pass. Here comes Oshie. From the dot, he scores.
This is a tough one to give up early here in the second period.
You get out of the first period 2-2, playing good the second half of that period. This is just a great stretch pass to Oshie, who has a great wrister. But if you watch here, Peter Mrazek's moving back a bit. He doesn't have his speed center, and this is just a great stretch pass. Give it that. Oshie, yes, he has a ton of goals this year. He has a great wrist shot.
The Seal got hit in the face as he's making the change. What a heads-up pass in the middle. And for Mitch Marner, a little bit of a monkey off.
Back of his zone. Now this will be Ottawa's last rush with a man advantage. Runblad snaps it all the way down to the line. Here's Greening on a break. His shot scores! Colin Greening, power play goal.
First rush up the ice, but on this one, he makes a perfect strike. Way up top of your screen, take a look at Colin Greening, the rookie. Many people may not know, because he certainly doesn't play like one. But now has scored his fourth goal of the year. Maybe none more important than this one, as the Ottawa Senators get scored upon first of the game. But they showed urgency to get back in.
Closing the gap a little more on Tavares and getting tighter up to that puck.
Here comes a break for Helm, and it scores! Way to tie it up! Darren Helm, seconds later! And we're all even at ones on the Red Wings' first shot on goal.
Great pass by Erickson. Patience, stretch pass up, catching the Islanders off guard, sending them in on a 2-on-0. A nice quick shot by Darren Helm. Just like in Edmonton, through the wickets of Nabokov, who seems to have strained.
Is underway, and it was the top line that scored. They will start, and here's a chance for David Perron with a shot, and he scores! David Perron, 25 seconds into the period. The Oilers have the lead for the first time in this game.
Don't see a stretch pass too often with Dallas Eakins' formation in the defensive zone, but Taylor Hall picks up this puck, and a good job by Perron just to find that seam.
Jammed along by Lundqvist. A single shot on goal in that power play, but moving right in, here's Broussard! The outlet pass from the Rangers, but the area of the ice, a bad change by the defenseman of the Montreal Canadiens. Nobody knows who should be going. Here comes Derek Brassard, and it was Bouillon who didn't know if he should go or stay. Breakaway, big time goal there, shorts.
The top two lines in the game going head to head, and here's a stretch pass, Brown in again. Dustin Brown scores! The captain has done it again, and Los Angeles has a 3-2 lead.
For the Kings, and it's another long lead breakout pass. This from Voinoff. He catches the Coyotes with a spread between Ekman, Larson, and Klesla. Klesla doesn't shield off this lane from Brown as Ekman Larson's a step to the left, trying to deny the board
there. You know, you're the Arizona Coyotes in last place. You're playing the Predators.
Here comes Scotty Hartnell with the stretch pass. Brings it over and scores! Skating, and the Predators are on the board with a minute 43 to go in the period.
And just as I say, there's not a lot of space out there. The veteran Scott Hartnell finds some. What a great pass here. This is transition. Ryan Ellis right through the middle. And Scott Hartnell, I have no idea how he got this back to the net. Watch the stick. He's all over him, but he finds a way.
Puck squirts to the front of the net. Stasny taken down as he tried to get there. Players strewn all over the place in the Anaheim zone. Here's a breakaway pass. Bobby Ryan in again. Scores again!
What a pass. Slav take the peak, and now he's got a big lane. Bobby Ryan all the way to the blue line. He hoists a great saucer pass to Ryan. Remember, he went five-hole first time. This time, he goes high glove on J.S. Chiguer. Look at that pass by Ryan Getzlaf. And a beautiful finish from Bobby Ryan.
A little bit of the Keystone Cops there as they almost played into their advantage as the Tampa Bay D were stymied.
Here's Callahan with a long shot. He scores! On a change, Callahan was on his own. He wired a slap shot and beat Corey Crawford. It's 1-0 Tampa Bay.
Here's the beginning of the shift for Callahan. A hard hit on Sharp that Sharp looked around, wanted a penalty. A long stretch pass that beats Johnny Aduya to the outside. But this is a perfect shot, but it's one that Corey Crawford's got to have.
You had Van Riemsdyk on the ice. It was his first shift.
Trevor Van Riemsdyk, Marcus Kruger, stretch pass, Josh Juras back in today, right in! Saros can't get it! Josh Juras!
push the right button. Two former Hawks, three actually team up. Darling, Van Riemsdyk, and Kruger. And it's Kruger that makes the beautiful transition pass to Juris at top speed, on sides. Look at the way that Juris gains the separation with his shot.
And overall, stretch pass, Yashkin in the clear, walks in, a shot, he scores! Yashkin, and it's 2-0.
Dean again, head up all the way through the middle of the ice. Oh my goodness, what a brilliant pass. Absolutely outstanding. Right between Schuster and Hedman. That's just a long length of stick that puck's got to go through, and Steen finds the mark, and what a finish there by Dmitry Yashkin. Boy, he finding his way.
Played offside, his wipe. Long toss by Keith, the turn and take by Kane.
Maybe the game's changed.
Well, not that much.
Klingberg has a man free, and Sagan moving in. Sagan, he scores! I call that tape to tape.
Well, they hooked up. The last game here, it was the goaltender to Sagan through the middle of the ice. Again, this is what both teams have been trying to expose the other side on. Long change second period. Transition from defenseman to a forward.
For the LA Kings, Yannick Weber comes out of the scrum, loops it down. Big play, Salamaki gets there and he scores! What a play! A beautiful loft pass by Weber to Salamaki, and the Predators are on the board.
Great job here, great sequence, and an excellent play. Yannick Weber and Matt Irwin played unbelievable last night, and they continue that. What a loft pass, an area pass. Mika Salamaki comes, Kemper goes for the poke check. He realizes that, short side upstairs. Excellent read, good heads up play.
Hamlin, tied up by Hamhuis, maintains the puck, long lead pass, sends Zucker in, he scores! What a pass this was though, my goodness, it landed right on Zucker's tape in full stride. This was the kind of pass that every player wants, right here. Just a long saucer pass, look how nice and soft it lands. That is perfect. Zucker didn't even have to break stride. That is what a good touchdown would look like.
Pass and out comes Bobrovsky, and it's left right there for Nudavara. Nudavara, long lead pass, Tyler Mott behind the defense. He shoots and scores his first as a Blue Jacket. And it's Columbus 3, Boston no score. What a pass by Nudavara.
Well, Nudavara's going back to get the puck on the right side of your screen. Out of your screen is Tyler Mott, and there he is. Behind the defender, that's Chara. He gets behind, right between the legs of Chara. That puck comes, Tyler Mott makes no mistake.
Behind the net, and a rushing defenseman would pick it up. This is assist that Marty Brodeur earned. A simple dumping, it's gloved down. And very quickly, Brodeur able to put that puck on the blade of his stick, look up ice, and have the confidence.
Curry with a little dusting prior to it. And then springs Sagan. He didn't even know the initial one went in. A little hockey language, a little stick language.
Tip. And then Nathan Beaulieu gets the puck through center. Pacioretty trying to catch up to it. Scores!
Stretch pass off of Louis Erickson, and this is a perfect opportunity for Pacioretty. You got a rolling puck, no time to think, just protects his body to the inside.
And then Letang dropped one, the kick back onto Nash, long toss ahead, Pastrnak in alone, score!
In order to create offense, you have to defend. The Bruins find a way to block shots and
defend pretty well. And then watch number 20 in the center of your screen, Riley Nash. Tito's Pasternak's off to the races. The long stretch pass, Letang coming hard. Look at how Pasternak shields a puck away from Letang and finally finishes Matt Murray. Really smart body.
Steph got it towards the net and Joel Ward was knocked down. The puck was underneath him. Getzloff, great pass ahead as Perry's in behind the defense, and he scores! Two straight games where Getzloff springs Perry, and tonight he finishes.
Magic, just magic from Getzloff there. Look at the patience of Getzloff. He just waits and waits, and then he delivers the strike, and the shot by Corey Perry. Boy, I said after he scored that goal against the Panthers, from that moment, John, he looked like a different player. And this is just vintage Perry. It's decisive, it's a snap of the wrist, and he picks the corner perfectly. Goal number two.
Talbot was a little hesitant about a poke check. Here's Nash on a breakaway, to the net, scores! Rick Nash is on fire! His second of the game.
Just get him the puck. This is the net. And then a good defensive job against Okoso as Tavares made the pass. And then alert on the play.
12 minutes remaining, second period. Here comes Stamkos. Moving it on price. He scores! His first of the playoffs.
What a spectacular pass. You knew it at some point. It had to happen, right? With the speed, here's Garrison with the pass. And then what a move. Actually Ward more than one move to get Carey Price to go to his right. Stamkos goes back the other way. That shoulder move, what a play.
No, nothing new for Josh, but he's responded with a couple early goals.
And here's a lead pass for Strome. He shoots, he scores! Ryan Strome banks it off the post, past Luongo. Islanders lead it 2-1.
What a terrific pass. I believe that was Thomas Hickey. And Ryan, there's Thomas Hickey. He just slides it into the hole, and there's a sliding Olsen. Watch the fake. There it is, the double fake on the by the right-hander Ryan Strome. But what a play by Thomas Hickey, firing it out the middle. You talk about a picture-perfect pass, and then Ryan Strome with the double head fake, the patience, the smarts, the ability, the skill, and the smiles on the face, and the Islanders lead 2-1. Oh, a couple of smiles. Thomas Hickey, I'm not sure he tried to do that, but it sure did look good.